Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. So today I will show you how to add loader on ButtonClick using jQuery. I have created this view and on you can see there is one button about, and on click of about there is another page that is going to open. So on click of about you can see like sometimes there is some API you are hitting or like there is net connection issue, so it takes time to go to another page or get back like response from API. So you can simply add a loader to your website. So let me show you code. So I have one index.php in which you can see I have one class for progress, and inside that there is progress bar. After that there is some dummy text and an anchor tag for about, and some scripts are included. So now firstly let me hide my progress bar. So give style visibility hidden to my progress div, and let's go and check in browser. So you can see our progress bar is now hidden. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to animate my progress bar on click of button about. So let's go and do this. So on anchor tag firstly write on click, let's say write function progress bar and also pass event in that, and in script tag define that same function progress bar event, and stop like prevent default functionality to go to another page. So now on click I'll need to make my progress bar visible again. So write dollar pass progress class to it, then CSS pass visibility initial. Now let's go into browser and see that how it goes. Refresh and click on about. Now you can see progress bar is visible on click of a button. So after this I'll be like creating another function, let's say progress animation, in which I'll be like animating my progress bar. So for that write function progress animation and define one variable, let's say var value equals to 0, and in function progress animation increment that value with 5. So after this take the class of progress bar and pass CSS to it. So I'll be passing width to value percentage. So now let's go and see how that like goes in browser. So now refresh and click on about. So you can see progress bar is like increased. So but you can see now every time if I click on about then only its width is increasing. But what we want is on one time when I click on about, this progress bar should complete, like width should go to 100%. So for that I'll be using timeout, set timeout. So in set timeout I'll be sending my progress animation function and in 1500 milliseconds. So now let's go and refresh. So if I'll click on about, so you can see it's increasing without clicking again and again now, because set timeout is like calling progress function again after 1500 milliseconds. So let me just show you by inspect. So inspect and you can see my style width is increasing, but you can see after 100 also it's increasing, it's not stopping. So for that I need to put condition that if my value goes above 100 then I'll be putting one if condition. If value greater than 100 then do nothing, else I'll be setting my timeout on progress animation function. So now let's go and check in browser. So if I refresh again, so it's incrementing my width. So let's wait until it's get complete and we will see how much like width it's going to increment. So you can see after 105 it's stopped. So I need to put equals to with my condition, so write value equals to 100. And also let me show width in my progress bar. So I'm going to write HTML and just pass value percentage. So after this I want to add one more if condition. If value equals to, let's say, 25, or value equals to, let's say, 55, value equals to 85, then I'm going to set timeout to 1500 milliseconds. In else condition, I'm going to set timeout to, let's say, 50 milliseconds only. And why I'm doing is that, like, I want my animation to get like a little bit slower and then faster. So now let's go. So now let's go and check in browser, refresh and click on about button. So now you can see percentage is displaying, and you can see in there is some pause between, like, in when it's 25, it's 55 and 85. So after this, I'll be removing this progress bar after completion of 100%. So for that, in value greater than equals to 100, I'll be passing progress CSS visibility hidden. Now let's go and refresh again. Click on about and you can see progress bar is working, and after completion of 100, it is removed from my view. So after this, let me pass value equals to 0 in my button click function. So now let's go and refresh and click on about button. So right now it's completing its first time. And if I click on about button second time, then you can see its width, like, come backwards and then again start incrementing. So that's what I don't want. So what I need to do is I need to set width to 0% again. So if value greater than 100, then pass progress bar CSS width to 0% and HTML 0% as well. So now let's go and check into browser. So refresh and click on about button. So now you can see after completion, if I click on about button, so you can see now it's again starting from zero. So I have shown you how to add a loader on button click using jQuery in your website. I hope you like this video. Please like, share and subscribe to my channel. Thank you so much for watching.